As planners are one of the best-selling low-content books and digital products to sell in different online marketplaces, I know most of you are interested in creating planners on Canva. However, the problem with creating planners is that it is very time-consuming. Frankly, I think it's also boring. Because either you make weekly or daily planners, you have to add the dates manually and carefully, page by page. And this sometimes takes hours, especially for the one page per day planners. So, today is the day. After watching this video, you will stop adding the dates manually, page by page, and finish your future planner project faster than ever. Because I will show you how to do it with just one click. Then, you will have more time for marketing efforts or other projects. Let's get into it. Welcome to my channel. If you are new here, I talk about how to make money online by self-publishing no-content and low-content books on Amazon. If this sounds like something that you might be interested in, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell, so you don't miss out on any future content. This is the file that I made in my last Canva tutorial video. It's a college ruled paper with a vertical margin. As you see, the spacing between the horizontal lines is 0.281 inches exactly here, as it must be. If you don't know how to control the spacing between the horizontal lines on Canva, I have a video dedicated to only this subject on my channel. And we have these page numbers here. If you remember, I added them automatically with the Canva bulk rate feature in my previous video. Now, I will try to change this file to a simple daily planner page and add the dates to it. Firstly, let's just keep the first page and delete the rest. Because, after making some changes, we will recreate them. To do it, enter the grid view by clicking the grid view icon at the bottom corner of the editor. If you want to select multiple pages, hold Ctrl or Command on your keyboard and click on the other pages to add them to your selection. And delete them. Okay. Now, click the Close Grid View icon at the bottom corner of the editor. Let's also delete the vertical margin and a couple of lines from the top to create some space for the dates. Okay. Then, click the text icon on the left menu and add a subheading after. Move this text box to the up. As an example, write September for the month. I like the font Robota Condensed. Let's change it. Okay, I think the size looks good. Firstly, let's arrange the position of the September text box in the middle of the page. And be sure that the alignment of the text is in the center. Then, duplicate this text and drag the new one under the first one. And write 30 to the new text box as an example. As a last step, I want to write the day of the week just under them. So, duplicate the second text box and drag the new one just under them. Better to change the size of the text and make it smaller. Okay, now write Saturday as an example. I think it looks not bad, right? By the way, as you see here, we have two text boxes for the left and right side page numbers at the bottom of the page. If you watch my previous Canva tutorial video, I showed how to arrange their position. So I will not explain this part in this video. Now we will use the bulk rate feature of Canva. This feature is available to Canva Pro, Canva for Teams, Canva for Education, and Canva for non-profit users. If you don't have Canva Pro account yet, you may think to have one after watching this video, because I think it's a game-changer feature, and you can save lots of time while creating multiple versions of the same design with bulk crates. If you want to test it, there's a free trial link below in the description. From the editor side panel, select Apps. Under More from Canva, select Bulk Crates. Now, we will add our data here. You can enter your data manually or upload a CSV file that includes the data. I will show both of them. In this example, we have 5 variables: month, date, day of the week, left side page number, and right side page number. Therefore, I think it will be easier to use the CSV file option for this example. Firstly, check the calendar and prepare your data like this in an Excel file. As you see, we have 5 columns, meaning variables here. My data starts with the 25th of September here and finishes with the 24th of October to show you. You can arrange it as you wish. Each row shows a unique page. For example, here we say write September 25, Monday, and 1 on this page. And if you look here, one of the page number fields is blank for each row, as I don't want the page numbers to appear on the left and right sides together. You can check my Canva tutorial about page numbers if it's not clear to you. And if you look at the second row, we say write September 26, Tuesday, and 2 on this page. When you finish, save this file as a CSV file. Then, upload it in the Bulk Crate menu. As you see, it identifies our data fields here. Then, right-click the September text box, connect data, and select month. Right-click the 30 text box, connect data, and select date. Right-click the Saturday text box, connect data, and select day. Right-click the left side page number text box, connect data, and select page no left. Right-click the right side page number text box, connect data, and select page no right. Then, just click continue to proceed. You can untick the pages you don't want to use. Once done, click generate. The pages created in bulk will open on a new tab. Depending on your data size, it may take some time. Okay. Let's look at each page. Okay. September 25, Monday, our page number is on the left. September 26, Tuesday, our page number is on the right. And as you see, all seems quite good. Let me show them also on the grid view. Look at each of them. Our 5 variables are changing perfectly on each page. And we just did it with only one click. Isn't it great? As I said, if you want to test it, there's a free trial link below in the description. I just made a simple dated daily planner to show you. I think if you make a better page layout and use the bulk crate feature, you can make better final products faster than before. I just show you how to upload data with a CSV file. Let me also quickly show you how to enter the data manually with another page layout. I made this template on Canva. However, there are no page numbers here. You can add them if you want, like I just showed you. In this example, I just want to use 3 variables on each page: month, date, and day of the week. From the editor side panel, select Apps. Under More from Canva, select Bulk Crate. click Enter Data manually. We have only two columns here. As we will have three variables, we need another column. Therefore, click Add Text. Now let's change the first column's name to Month. And change the second column's name to Date. And the third column's name to Day. As we did for the CSV file, prepare your data here. I think manually entering the data is useful when you are planning to create fewer pages. Therefore, I will not make this example for a full month. Let's do it for 2 weeks. When you finish, click Done. As we did before, right-click the September text box, connect data, and select Month. Right-click the 30 text box, connect data, and select Date. Right-click the Saturday text box, connect data, and select Day. Then, just click Continue to proceed. All data is selected by default. You can untick the pages you don't want to use. Once done, click Generate. The pages created in bulk will open on a new tab. Okay. Let's look at each page. As you see, all three variables are changing on each page without any problem. And when your data is ready, it's fast and works perfectly. What do you think? As I said, I think bulk create is a game-changer feature for Canva. Today, I showed you how to create dated planner pages with this feature. I think it will accelerate your product creation time. If you want me to make more videos about the Canva bulk create or other Canva features, please write to me in the comment section below. I remind you, bulk create is available to Canva Pro. And there's a free trial link below in the description to upgrade your Canva free version account to Canva Pro. I hope this video was worth watching. If you think so, make sure to subscribe and like the video to support the channel. See you soon in the next video.